weekend. Charges could be coming down soon. We have the very latest from the scene. First, though, we need to check in with Guy for the cool start to the week.
Yeah, getting ready to step out, maybe grab a cup of coffee. Temperatures are in the 40s and 50s this morning. Zooming into the metro, you'll see some cooler spots towards Glencoe, 44 right now, and then Twin Cities coming in at 50 degrees. I'll let you know those afternoon high temperatures coming up.
All right, thank you, Guy. Taking a look right now in Bloomington. This is 494, where it meets 35 here. Things looking good. That continues to be the case across the metro, but we're going to take a closer look at those metro-wide traffic maps coming up in just a bit.
Three shots inside the bar. One's going outside with a 30 right now.
Shots fired. Multiple cars. We are getting calls currently of a person shooting.
Developing this morning, charges could come down soon in the deadly mass shooting in St. Paul. 15 people shot inside a packed bar early Sunday morning right by the XL Energy Center. One of the victims, Markeisha Wiley, died from her injuries. Her family says the 27-year-old was gunned down. They now want to know why this happened. Three people are in custody for the shooting right now, and it has without a doubt shaken the community. CC is live in St. Paul, where city leaders say this violence is going to keep happening. CC?
Yeah, as you mentioned, 27-year-old Markeisha Wiley was the woman who died on Sunday, making this St. Paul's 32nd homicide just this year. Now the pressure is on city leaders to try to clean up the streets. St. Paul Mayor Melvin Carter says that the city is spending $1 million in police overtime to patrol West 7th Street and train one of the largest academies in department history. He says the city is also working with the business owners, saying security teams at local bars can help police watch for potential problems. But Carter is taking it a step further by calling on lawmakers to help get guns off the street.
And that action hopefully one day will include action at the state legislature that would engage, frankly, some of the lawmakers who are hoping to troll St. Paul today, but are literally the hurdles that are blocking us from being able to pass the type of sensible gun control reforms that Minnesotans and Americans want to see happen.
Carter went on to say that without these stricter gun laws, that shootings like this will continue to happen. Coming up in our next half hour, we hear from people who live in this area about the changes they want to see. Chris.
All right, CC, thank you. CC reporting live in St. Paul this morning. And Jen, this comes in an already deadly violent year for St. Paul.
Yeah, Chris. So this morning we're taking a closer look at that violence in St. Paul, homicides in particular. St. Paul police say overall violent crime is up in the city compared to last year. The city has had 32 homicides so far in 2021. All of last year, they had 34. We talked with Ward 2 City Council member Rebecca Naker, who said the city needs to continue to focus on curbing crime.
This is an area where we have been putting in a ton of time and resources. Our police officers are here overtime on a regular basis, trying to make sure that when people come to St. Paul, they're safe and they can have a good time, which is exactly what the street is all about.
Meanwhile, Governor Walz has called the shooting horrific. He tweeted that the state's keeping in our hearts the victims and the St. Paul neighborhood reeling from this senseless gun violence. Senator Klobuchar tweeted that the shooting was an appalling tragedy and said it must be a call to action. This shooting has generated a lot of discussion about public safety in St. Paul and the Twin Cities as a whole. SCC mentioned St. Paul Mayor Melvin Carter said in his statement that work to build more proactive and comprehensive public safety strategies is more urgent now than ever. Chris.
There has to be an answer to this, and hopefully community leaders and the community can come together for a solution. Thanks, Jen. Well, take a look at your screen. This video is 10 minutes before bullets started flying. DJ Peter Parker was performing that night. He says it was all laughs and a fun party until that first gun went off.
Everyone dove on the ground, and it was really like a panic situation. I shut the music off, and then I kind of maneuvered myself off the stage. And then it was like trying to see what happened.
Coming up at 6:30, we hear from Ramsey County sheriffs who just one night before the mass shooting predicted this would happen. Now, there is still so many questions about the mass shooting, and we are looking for answers. Stay with KARE 11 on our website and all our social medias for the very latest on the tragedy in St. Paul. Breaking COVID news this morning, we could be just weeks away from another new weapon to fight COVID. Merck just submitted for full FDA approval of its COVID-fighting pill. The company says in trials, the pill helped cut hospitalizations and deaths related to COVID. If cleared by the FDA, it would be the first pill shown to treat the virus. And some good signs across the country when it comes to COVID.
The 7-day average of cases is below 100,000. It's about 95,000. Hospitalizations are down below 10,000, around 7,400. And deaths are down below 2,000. They're now around 1,400.
Good news, right? But Dr. Fauci warns this pandemic is far from over. Even here in Minnesota, cases are still rising. Now health experts are worried some pockets of the country will be hit with a twindemic as flu season ramps up. Fall is here, and that means those annoying quick colds are back. Brandon Lewis verifies if some at-home remedies actually work.
Cold season is right around the corner, and many people are searching for ways to relieve their symptoms. A top Google search asks whether salt water can cure a sore throat, a common symptom of a cold. So let's verify. Does gargling salt water actually cure a sore throat? Our sources are a doctor at the Indiana School of Medicine, the University of Pennsylvania Health System, and the Mayo Clinic. Both Penn Medicine and the Mayo Clinic suggest mixing 8 ounces of warm water with a half teaspoon of salt and gargling the mixture to provide some relief. But it's not an exact science.
Most of these are passed down from generation to generation to generation, and it's just kind of what people have done for symptom relief. But this has not been rigorously scientifically studied.
Penn Medicine says gargling a combination of salt and water can help loosen mucus and ease pain from a sore throat. Salt water can also help kill bacteria, but it won't do much for a viral infection, including COVID-19.
Some people may have relief with the sore throat that comes along with COVID, and that's great if you want to use it for that reason. I think my fear with information like this is that people use salt water, they think they're no longer infectious, and they start doing things that they probably shouldn't be doing.
So it's false that gargling salt water can cure a sore throat, but it can temporarily provide relief from one. With your Verify, I'm Brandon Lewis.
Now here's a look at today's other top stories in your morning rush. Prosecutors will push for a longer sentence if Kim Potter is convicted in the death of Dante Wright. The former Brooklyn Center police officer says she meant to reach for her taser when she shot and killed Wright. If Potter is convicted of the most serious charge of first-degree manslaughter, she would face up to 8.5 years in prison. If the prosecution gets its way, she could receive up to 15 years. Her trial begins at the end of November. And look at these prices. The national average for a gallon of gas has jumped nearly 6 cents in the past 2 weeks to around $3.26. Here in the Twin Cities, you'll pay about $3.07 a gallon. And a merger between TCF and Huntington Banks is turning into a mess for some customers. Many say when they tried using their debit card this weekend, they got messages like insufficient funds or card declined. The company says this was because of a conversion error and are working to fix the error. And the